In this video, we will learn about set and dart. Set is another data structure and we use set to store unique collection of items. So set is an unordered collection of unique objects. And in dart, you can define a set using set literal. So the same way we will define a var, so we can write var and again names equals to, and we define set literal using a pair of curly braces. Now this is our set names. Now inside the set, we can store unique elements. For example, if I try to store some duplicate elements inside the set, then let's see what happens. So I will write John and then Peter, and I will write Peter again, and let's say Tony and Tony again. Now this also supports a trailing comma at the end of the last element, and you can see it is giving us warnings. Two elements in a set literal shouldn't be equal. So it is saying us that you should not have duplicate elements inside your set. But what if we try to print the names? So if we print the names, we get John, Peter, and Tony only. So it created the set only with unique items. So it is not possible to put duplicate elements inside a set. In this case, we have defined a set of type string. If you want to define an empty set, then just before this set literal, that is a pair of curly braces, you need to define the type for your set. In this case, I want to define an empty set. So I will write here string like this inside angular braces. So now we have a set names that is of type string. Now we can add elements inside this set using the functions. So we can write names.add. And you can use these functions, add to add a single element, add all to add multiple elements. And you can also use remove all to remove all the elements from the set. You can use clear to clear the set. So this function removes all elements from the set. Set also supports the spread operator that we learned in the last video. So if you want to create a new set, for example, this is a set of A, B, and C, and I want to create one more set, let's say var names 1, and I can create this set using this names set. So I want to add some more elements, for example, 1, 2, and 3, and then I can use the spread operator and then names. Now it will create a new set that will contain 1, 2, 3, and ABC. So if I print names 1 here, you can see we are getting all the elements of the set. You can also use for loop for traversing your set. For example, I can write here for var name in names 1 like this, and I can print the name. And you can see we are getting all the values. And again, you can also use the null safety operator here to make your set creation null safe if you think that this might be null in some cases. And set also supports the if and for loops for inserting elements. For example, here I can write if some condition is true, then insert D. And I can also write for where I equals to 0, I is less than 5, I plus plus, and here I will insert di. I will make it on the second line so that you can see it clearly. I will format the code like this. So you can use if else and you can also use for. Now if I print, let's say, names, then what happens is we get all the values from our set. We are getting this warning because we are using this null safety operator here that is not required, so we can remove this thing. But you can use it if you think your names can be null. So you can see we are getting all the values. So all the operations are like list only. The difference is set can only contain unique element. And one more thing, if you add something inside a set, for example, I want to add something in set, then this function, that is add, it returns a bool value. Now this will return true if the value is successfully added inside the set. If the value is not added, that means this value already exists in the set. In that case, we will receive false as the return type from this add function. So this is how you can use set in your Dart program. So that is all for this video, friends. Thanks for watching.